Hey guys, welcome back to World Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video guys to any of you having a gear optimer. And if you're leaking coolant from the water pump guys, we'll explain the top 3 things where you can develop a coolant leak from a water pump. Also, every time you replace that pump, we'll explain which one to buy. Okay, and also what you need to do and what not to do, because that can severely overheat your engine and you may end up buying a new engine. So stay with us, we'll cover that today. We'll demonstrate on a 2.4 GDI engine guys, but even if you have a similar engine or different engine, the video should be helpful as well. So let's go ahead, cover that. With the engine being out, we can clearly demonstrate everything. So as we said, that should work on most generation Kia Sportage, Kia Sorento guys. Before we start, let me tell you, every single car we get at the garage, we try to make at least 200 to 300 free repair videos guys. We take them completely apart and we show you how to fix pretty much anything. Why we do that? Simply because our mission in the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need in return, please guys, subscribe to the channel and like the video. Now, if you guys need to buy any parts or tools for a really good price and quick shipping as well, check out the link in the description of the video below and you can see where we get all our tools and parts from. So with that being said, let's explain how we're going to do that now. So this right here is a 2.4 GDI engine guys. We have the water pump removed. Okay, that's our water pump. You can see this is the gasket right here for the water pump. Usually, okay, you'll be able to find a water pump on the rear side of the engine, towards the cabin, towards the firewall. This is the crankshaft. You can see on the front you have alternator AC compressor, on the back is a water pump. Now, if you develop a leak guys, one thing where you can develop a leak is the gasket, the water pump gasket. Every time you remove the pump or replace it, you need to put new gasket. But also, you need to guys clean everything really good. Okay, if you have that black stuff, you need to clean it good. It needs to be even. Otherwise, okay, the new gasket can develop a leak. Number two guys, the pump itself can easily fail. And right here you have on the inside seals that prevent the coolant from leaking from the axle, because that axle is spinning. You can see how it's turning, right? Now, when that seal fails, okay, you can develop a leak from the water pump, from the pulley right here, it will be dripping. And that can easily, guys, cause leaks as well on higher mileage pumps. Also, guys, when you buy pumps, buy them the one with the metal fan on the inside. If you have the plastic one, they can fall apart, when they get old, and that can severely overheat your engine as well. Number three, guys, you have one O-ring on the water pump housing. That water pump housing attaches to the cylinder block right here. You can see with 1, 2, 3, 4 bolts, I believe. Five bolts. And if you look through here on the inside, you can see the O-ring, but right here on the back side of the water pump housing, you have the pipe that goes to the thermostat housing, and that coolant pipe guys has an O-ring. That O-ring can develop a leak and it can start dripping towards the pump, and you may think you have a better water pump when all we had to do replace that O-ring right here for the pipe. So always inspect that as well. Those are the top three coolant water pump leaks. If you have any questions, let us know. Thank you for watching and see you guys next time.